This is electricity trainer. Order code of this trainer is 335515 is the order code of this instrument. On the panel, different block diagrams are provided. This is your first block, DC power supply, 5 volt at 200 milliampere. Second block, again DC power supply, 12 volt at 200 milliampere. Third, AC power supply, 6 volt at 1 ampere. This is toggle switch, on-off switch, block number 6. This is galvanometer, and these are the input terminals for this galvanometer. And these are the terminals of the toggle switch point, bulb, 6 volt bulb, another bulb, and this is third bulb. This is the point for the multimeter connection for the multimeter. This is relay, 12 volt relay, and these are the two potentiometer. This is 25 ohm, and these are the input terminals of this potentiometer. And these are the 10k, this is the 10k potentiometer, and this is another 10k potentiometer, and this is buzzer. So around 20 experiments can be performed on this trainer. So first experiment is to study the resistance individually as well as in series and in parallel connections. This is the component box which is supplied with this instrument, and these are the different resistance. So first is resistance in series. Resistance are said to be connected in series between two points if they provide only a single path between the two points. So resistance in series, take any two of resistance. This is breadboard. First end of this first resistor, and this is second end of this first resistor, and this is your second resistor, and first end of this second resistor is connected to second end of first resistor. So these two resistances are in series. Second is resistances in parallel. For the parallel connection of resistance, both resistance are in now parallel connection. All holes in this bar vertically connected, and this is upper half. All holes are vertically connected. So this end of this resistor is connected to first end of the second resistor, and this is the second end of first resistor which is connected to second end of second resistor. So both resistance are in parallel connection. Take any two or three resistors or of same value, enter the color code of resistors into the table. A table is provided in our manual. Enter the value of resistors according to the color code in the table. Enter the tolerance in the table. Measure the resistance of all three resistors with the help of multimeter. You can measure the value of these resistance with the help of this multimeter and note down the value of these resistors in table which is provided in our manual. This is your first resistance value and this is your second resistance value. So note down the value of these resistances in the table which is given. Now connect three resistors in series on the tenor board. Measure the resistance of the combination as shown in the following diagram. A diagram is provided. By connecting the leads of the multimeter between the points at the end of shown arrow, this is your arrow, you can calculate the resistances by using formulas and can compare with the multimeter readings. So you can connect three resistances in series and according to the manual you can measure the value of these resistances with the help of multimeter. This is your first resistance. This is your second resistance and this is your third resistance and this is the resistance value of both resistances and this is the value of all three resistances. So you can measure the value of these resistors with the help of multimeter. Now connect the resistors in parallel as shown in figure 3. Measure the resistance of different combinations. Now you can take different type of resistor values and repeat the above steps. You can take the another resistors, construct a combination of series and parallel connections. This is your parallel and series connection. So you can connect the resistors in different combination, series combination or parallel combination, and measure the overall resistance or individual resistance in each combinations and study the parallel and series combination of resistors. So here object number 2 is to study the Ohm's law mathematical relationship between three variable voltage, current and resistance. Take any one resistor from the given component box for this experiment. For the second experiment we have taken this resistance. You can detect its value from the last experiment and record it in the table. So this is your 100 ohm resistance. Now connect the circuit as shown in figure. This is the figure for the connections. This is 5 volt supply, this is emitter and this is your resistor. For the measurement of current, this is your arrow mark, 20 milliampere range, this is 200 milliampere range. So keep this, first you keep this selector switch to 200 milliampere current range. And milliampere current range, for the milliampere current range, lead is connected to this point. So according to the diagram, plus 5 volt supply, this is your plus 5 volt DC supply. Connect this DC supply to, this is your plus 5 volt DC supply. Connect this DC supply to positive terminal and this is your positive lead. You can connect directly and this is your negative, and negative of the emitter is connected to the resistance. You can use the crocodile clip for the connection. another end of this resistance is connected to negative terminal of the power supply. You can use black lead for the negative connection. This is your negative terminal of 5 volt power supply, which is connected to directly one end of resistor, and other end of resistor is connected to ampere meter, and second end of ampere meter is connected to positive supply. So now your connection according to this figure is completed. Connect a resistor one end to ammeter and other end to negative terminal of DC power supply. Connect positive of DC power supply to other end of ammeter. Set the multimeter to the appropriate range and measure the current flowing through the resistance. Record this value of current in the table. This is the table. So record the value. Switch on the unit. And this is the value of current at 5 volt supply. At 5 volt, this is the current value 50.2 or 3 milliampere. So record this value in the table. Now disconnect the above setup and connect the new circuit. Switch off the trainer and connect the new circuit. This is your new circuit. Connect a resistor across the DC power supply. DC power supply is directly connected across the resistor. Same resistor. We can use same resistor for the connections. This is your positive. And positive terminal is directly connected to one end of resistance, and negative is directly connected to other end of this resistance. So now power supply is connected to the across the resistor. Connect a voltmeter across the resistance. For the voltmeter range, this is your arrow mark. Now this arrow mark is in 20 volt position, so keep this arrow mark at 20 volt position and connect this voltmeter across the resistance. Switch on the trainer and connect this voltmeter across the resistance. So value of the voltage is 5.12 volt. Now measure the voltage. This is 5.12 across the resistor. Note that value is voltage is to be measured in the parallel. Record the corresponding voltage and current in the table for different resistors. You can start with lower value of resistors. Draw graph between current vertical axis and resistance horizontal axis. It is clear that current is inversely proportional to the resistance, so you can draw the graph with the help of these readings. So this is your experiment second. So now we are going to experiment third. This is to study the voltage and current flowing into the circuit. For this experiment, connect the three resistors of same value in the series circuit. Connect the three resistors in series and measure the voltage drop. You can measure the voltage drop with the help of this multimeter and note down the reading of V1, V2 and V3. and this is the parallel combination, parallel circuit. Measure the voltage across each of the resistors and combination with the help of this multimeter. You can connect the resistor on this breadboard in series or parallel. Connect the combination of series and parallel circuit. You can connect the series of and parallel also on this breadboard and measure the different voltage at different point at different resistance and note down the reading with the help of this multimeter. Connect the parallel circuit of resistance and measure the current. You can measure the current with the help of this figure, and this is your multimeter. You can use this meter as a current meter also. When you put this selector switch to emitter range, this will read current. So you can connect the this meter as a current meter according to this figure. So you can do the experiment third. This is easy experiment. This is simply parallel or series combination of different resistors. So now your object 4. Object 4 is a study of the behavior of current when light bulbs are connected in series and parallel circuits. So we are going to do your object 4, experiment 4. We have connected these three bulbs according to this figure. You can see on the panel current flows in the circuit. It is equally divided in the two parallel branches. These are two parallel branches, but flows in full amount through the series bulb. This is series bulb. These are the parallel connected bulbs. Result of this is parallel bulbs are glowing with low intensity and series is glowing with full light. So this is the behavior of current when light bulbs are connected in series or parallel circuit. Object 5 is to study the Kirchhoff law for electrical circuits. This is the circuit diagram for object 5. According to this figure, we are going to connect all resistance on this breadboard. This is the breadboard. You can use this breadboard to make a circuit diagram according to the figure 16. We have connected the circuit diagram according to this figure for the study of Kirchhoff law for electrical circuits. According to the procedure, measure outgoing current I1, I2. So this is your input current A and J point. This is your A point. This is your J. Connect A terminal. To positive end of 5 volt power supply and negative terminal of power supply connected to your J terminal. For the measurement of input current, use this multimeter. This is milliampere range. Switch on the tailor. This is your input current 10.2 milliampere. I in. This is I1 current. I1 current is flowing in this branch and this is I2. So for the measurement of I1, disconnect one end of this resistance 100 ohm. Here you can see this resistance is 100 ohm R5. So disconnect the first end of this resistance and measure your I1. This is your I1, 7.6 milliampere. For the measurement of I2, disconnect the one end of R2 resistance. This is your R2. This is 220 ohm resistance. So just disconnect the first end of this resistance for the measurement of I2. This is your I2. Milliampere. Again connect this resistance. This is your I2 and this is I3. For the measurement of I3, disconnect the R6. This is your R6, 100 ohm resistance. Disconnect the upper end of this R6 resistance and connect the multimeter in series with this resistance, and this is your 1.9 milliampere and this is your I3. So you can measure the different current value in this circuit with the help of this multimeter. So measure current I out between point J and one end of resistor R10. Calculate the different IR drop in ABIJ loop. Measure the sum of IR drop with their sign. Equate the sum of all IR drops with their sign and sum of the source voltage of that particular loop. It should be equal. In case of no voltage source in loop, take the sum of all voltage sources equal to 0. Repeat above procedure for loop BCHI. This is your BCHI loop, CDGH loop. This is your CDGH loop, and for the loop DEFG, you can use DEFG, this loop. So repeat the above procedure for loop BCHI, CDGH and DEFG. So you can study the Kirchhoff's law for electrical circuits with the help of this trainer, with the help of digital multimeter and the measurement by the measurement of different current value in different branches. Experiment 6 is to study the RC circuit and find out the behavior of capacitor in a RC network and study the phase shift due to the capacitor. For this object, connect the circuit diagram. So this is the circuit diagram. Remove all resistance which we have connected for the object 5th Kirchhoff law. This is 5 volt DC supply block 1. This is your block 1 and positive terminal. This is positive terminal and this is negative terminal of this 5 volt DC supply. This is 100 k resistance, so take one 100 k resistance. So this is your 100 k resistance. Connect this resistance and one end of this resistance is connected to 100 microfarad capacitor. This is your 100 microfarad capacitor. First end of this 100 k resistor is connected to block 6 switch. This is your block 6 and this is your toggle switch. So connect the first end of this resistor to the one terminal of this toggle switch. So K1 is connected to first end of this resistor, 100 k resistor, and common point or another terminal of this switch is connected to positive supply for the on off operation of this power supply. This connection is for the on off. So now your plus 5 volt supply, plus 5 volt supply is connected by a switch to the 100 k resistance, and negative end of this capacitor is connected to directly connected to negative terminal of 5 volt power supply. Now your circuit is completed. Connect the voltmeter across the capacitor. This is positive. And this is your negative. So we have connected this voltmeter across the capacitor. Put the toggle switch in off condition. If there is some remaining voltage, this is remaining voltage on the capacitor, use a piece of wire to short two leads together, draining any remaining voltage, any remaining charge. So just short the capacitor by with the help of this lead. So now your reading is exactly zero, no charge at the capacitor. Capacitor is fully discharged. Now if you put the toggle switch in on condition, first you switch on the trainer. Now if you put the toggle switch in on condition, you can observe voltmeter that capacitor is charging very fast. So we are going to on this switch and voltmeter will show the voltage, charging voltage across the capacitor. This is your charging voltage, capacitor is charging. After few seconds, the rate of charging is slow. Capacitor is charging very fast starting at the starting, but after few seconds, the rate of charging is slow. Now your rate of charging is very slow. You can see this is very slow charging. Now put the toggle switch in off condition and connect a wire from first end of resistor to second end of capacitor. Here we can observe the charging is flowing back. So we are going to connect first end of this resistor. This is the first end of this resistor. Connect this wire to the negative lead of capacitor for the discharging, and meter, you can see on the meter, this is discharging. In a start it discharges very fast, but after few seconds discharging is slow. This is slow discharging. You can record the time of charging TC and time of discharging TD for a given value of resistor. This is 100k resistor and a capacitor 100 microfarad capacitor. Now you can change the value of resistors and capacitor and record the value of TC and TD in the table. The table is given in our manual. Replace the electrolytic capacitor of previous circuit with metallic polyester capacitor. For the phase shift, replace this capacitor from a polyester capacitor. This is your polyester capacitor. And replace the DC supply with AC. This is your AC supply. And switch on the trainer and switch on the toggle switch. Now measure the voltage across the resistor and capacitor. AC power supply source is 6 volt and 1.4 volt is the voltage which are available across the capacitor. And 5.2 volt is across the resistor, 100k resistor. Voltage across the 100k resistor is 5.2 volt AC, and across the capacitor this is 1.4 volt. You will find that voltage drop across the resistor and across the capacitor 1.4 and 5.2. It do not add up to equal the total of 6 volt. This is due to phase shift in the circuit. Voltage dropped across the capacitor is out of phase with voltage drop across the resistor, and thus the voltage drop do not add up as one might expect. So this is your object 6. 7 is to study the LC circuit and its oscillations. So for this experiment, remove all previous connection. For this experiment, this is the circuit diagram. This is 5 volt power supply. This is 0.1 microfarad capacitor, 800 turn coil. So you can take, this is your 800 turn coil. So put this coil and connect it, one end of this coil directly, first end of this coil directly connected to positive supply, positive DC supply, and another end of this coil is connected to K2. K2 is the terminal of toggle switch. Take 0.1 microfarad capacitor. This is your 0.1 microfarad capacitor, and one end of this capacitor is also connected to plus 5 volt supply, and this is also connected to plus 5 volt supply. And other end of this capacitor is connected to common of toggle switch, connected to common of this toggle switch. Negative of the power supply is connected to K1. It is a LC circuit. As you switch on the trainer board and continuously switch on and off the toggle switch, you can observe the oscillations in oscilloscope. So connect your oscilloscope across the capacitor. You can connect the oscilloscope across the capacitor. So now your oscillator is connected across the capacitor. This is your normal mode. Switch on the trainer. You can see on the screen these are the oscillations. So we are continuously on and off this toggle switch. For the observation of oscillations on the CRO screen, you can observe the oscillations in oscilloscope, because if an inductor and capacitor are connected in parallel with each other and then power is fed by a DC voltage source, oscillations will ensure as energy is exchanged from the capacitor to inductor and vice versa. Parallel inductor capacitor circuits are known as tank circuit. Its natural frequency is called resonant frequency and can be determined with the help of formula which is given in our manual. So you can observe this oscillations in CRO screen by the continuous on off the toggle switch. So this is the object 7 for the observation. Continuously on and off the toggle switch. Next objective, to study the characteristics of its semiconductor diode. For this experiment, remove all previous connections. And this is the circuit diagram for the characteristic, study the characteristic of semiconductor diode. So connect this circuit diagram. We are going to connect this circuit diagram according to the manual. So positive 5 volt DC is connected to 25 ohm 1 watt block 12. This is your block 12. And another end of this potentiometer, 25 ohm 1 watt potentiometer, is connected to negative terminal of this power supply. And center point of this potentiometer is connected to 1K resistance. And this is center point of this potentiometer, which is connected to 1K resistance. And in this box, you can see 1K resistance. This is your 1K resistance and diode. And this is your semiconductor diode. cathode of this diode is directly connected to a ampere meter. For the measurement of current, switch on the trainer. This is the current 4.1 milliampere which is flowing in the circuit. Vary the potentiometer so as to increase the value diode voltage in step of 100 millivolt. Connect one multimeter point A and B, it means across the diode. So another voltmeter we can connect, or we can use the single multimeter. This is another voltmeter. Vary the potentiometer and this is your 0.65 volt across the diode. Very good. With the help of this potentiometer, you can vary the voltage drop across the diode. And at the different voltages, you can note down the different current reading in the circuit. This is the current reading which is flowing in this circuit. Record the diode current with corresponding diode voltage in table. Plot a curve between diode voltage and current. This is the graph. This curve is required forward characteristic of silicon diode. Using suitable scale with the help of observation table. For reverse bias characteristics, just revert the polarity of this diode and you can take the current reading and voltage reading. Plot a curve between diode voltage and diode current. Object 9 is to study the characteristics of a transistor. For this object, this is the circuit diagram. So we are going to connect this circuit diagram. Switch off the trainer. This is your 547 transistor. plus 5 volt power supply block 1, positive terminal of the supply is connected to 10k P1. This is your 10k block 13. So positive terminal of this supply is connected to one end of this 10k. Other end of this 10k is directly connected to negative terminal of this power supply. Center point of this power supply is connected to 5k1, 5.1 kilo ohm resistance. 5.1 kilo ohm resistance. This is 5.1 kilo ohm resistance, which is directly connected to base of this transistor. This is your 5.1 kilo ohm resistance. Center point of this potentiometer is connected to this resistance. Emitter of this transistor is connected to ground terminal, negative terminal. This is your emitter terminal of this transistor, which is directly connected to negative terminal of this power supply. Collector of this transistor is connected to 100 ohm resistance. This is your 100 ohm resistance. Collector of this transistor is connected to 100 ohm resistance. Other end of this 100 ohm resistance is connected to second 10k resistance. One end of this 10k potentiometer. This is your another 10k potentiometer. Center point of this potentiometer. First end of this potentiometer is connected to plus 12 volt power supply, positive terminal of plus 12 volt power supply, and negative terminal of this power supply is connected to third end of this potentiometer. All ground connections are common. Connect a voltmeter across collector and emitter of transistor. This is your voltmeter, and connect this voltmeter across the collector and emitter of this transistor. This is your collector. And this is emitter. Connect the voltmeter across the collector and emitter. And set VCE at some constant value, say 1 volt, switch on the trainer, and set VCE to 1 volt. Now VCE is set to 1 volt. Now vary the potentiometer P1 so as to increase the value of input voltage. VBE. VB is 0 at first. Set this to 1 volt. This is your 1 volt VCE. And now vary the potentiometer P1 so as to increase the value of input voltage VBE from 0 to 0.8 volt in a step. Point 2, point 3, this is point 4, point 5, point 6, point 7, point 8, point 9. In a step and measure the corresponding value of input current IB by connecting a ammeter in series between resistance 5.1K and base of the transistor. So for the measurement of current, suppose this is 0.3, at 0.3 input voltage, measure the input current with the help of this multimeter. These are the multimeter probe. And this is the current setting of this multimeter. So, for the measurement of input current IB, for the measurement of IB, this is your IB. At 0.3 voltage, this is 0. Again, connect. This is 0.4. At 0.4, note down the IB base current. Put the same meter in series. This is again 0. This is voltage setting. Now measure the VBE, 0.5. Again measure the input current, change the proper setting. VBE 0. This is now VB is 0.7 approximately. At this condition, your IB is 155 microampere. So repeat the error procedure for different constant value of VCE. Now plot a curve between input voltage VBE and input current IB as shown in theory. This is the observation table. You can take the different reading of base current at the different value of input voltage and also different value at the different values of collector to emitter voltage, and we have set it to 1 volt. You can set at 3 volt also. 5 volt also with the help of potentiometer P2, block 14, 10K potentiometer. This is the 10K potentiometer in block 14. This is your block 14, and this potentiometer is connected to 12 volt DC. For the output characteristics, switch off the supply, rotate both the potentiometer P1 and P2 in fully counterclockwise position. Switch on the power supply, vary the potentiometer and set a value of input current IB at some constant value. Say 10 microampere or 100 microampere by connecting a meter between resistor 5K. Vary the potentiometer P2 so as to increase the value of output voltage from 0 to maximum value in a step. Measure output current IC by connecting a meter between collector of transistor and 100 ohm resistor. Repeat the procedure for different value of input current and plot a curve between output voltage and output current. Object 10. To understand the Faraday's law of electromagnetic induction, for this experiment, take any coil from the given coil set. This is 200 turns coil. Let the two ends of the coil connected to the two terminal of galvanometer. This is your galvanometer. This is 200 turns coil. Now take a bar magnet. This is bar magnet. And keep it north pole stationary near one end of the coil. The galvanometer shall not show any deflection when magnet is stationary. When the magnet is moved toward the coil, the galvanometer shows deflection. This is the deflection. When the magnet is moved away from the coil, the galvanometer again shows deflection, but in opposite direction. Similar results are obtained when the magnet is kept stationary and the coil is moved. And this is the Faraday's law of electromagnetic induction. Now object 11th is to study the behavior of current when inductance is introduced in the circuit. For this experiment, a circuit diagram is shown in our manual. Take 1600 turn coil. This is 1600 turns coil, and connect one end of this coil to 6 volt AC power supply. Another end of this coil is connected to a 6 volt bulb. Another end of the 6 volt bulb is connected to the second end of AC power supply. Now as you switch on the trainer, you can observe the light bulb is glowing with good intensity. This is the take I core. This is your I core. Insert in the coil, result will be the light of decreased intensity. You can see intensity of the bulb is decreased when I core is inserted in the coil. The glow of the bulb will decrease because as the iron rod is inserted in the coil, its inductance increases, so inductive reactance increases. This results in an increase in impedance of the circuit. Consequently, the current in the circuit decreases and hence the glow of the bulb decreases. So this is your object 11. Now we are going to object 12. This is to study the Lenz law and effect of eddy current. For this experiment, circuit diagram is shown in our manual. This is the circuit diagram, plus 5 volt DC supply, and this is your toggle switch, which is in block 6. Connect DC power supply, positive of the DC power supply, to the U core. This is your U core. Put this U core on the stand which is provided on the panel and take a coil. This is 200 turns coil. We are using 200 turns coil. One end of this coil is directly connected to positive of plus 5 volt supply. Another end of this coil is connected to toggle switch, a terminal of this toggle switch, and common point of this toggle switch is connected to negative terminal of plus 5 volt supply. Take a soft iron square piece from the accessories, soft iron piece. These are the soft iron piece which is supplied with our with this strainer. As you switch on the toggle switch, the metallic piece is thrown up. You can see this metallic piece is thrown up. When we switch on this toggle switch, switch on the supply, this metallic piece is thrown up. Because when current begins to grow through the coil, the magnetic flux through the core and hence metallic piece begins to increase. So this is the experiment 12, Lenz law and effect of eddy current. Now we are going to object 13. Object 13 is to study the relay and construct a switching circuit by using relay. This is your relay, and for this experiment this is the connection diagram. Relay block 10, first end of this relay coil is connected to 12 volt DC supply, and this is the relay coil which is connected to positive terminal of DC power supply, and another end of this coil, relay coil, is connected to block 6 toggle switch, and another terminal of this toggle switch is connected to negative of this 12 volt power supply, NC terminal of this relay is connected to block 3 AC power supply, another terminal of this AC power supply is connected to 6 volt bulb, AC bulb, and also connected to a buzzer. This is your buzzer. Six volt AC bulb, another terminal, second terminal of this bulb is connected to NC contact. NC and NO is connected to the buzzer. This is NO, which is connected to buzzer. Keep the toggle switch in off condition. Now at this time switch is in off condition. Now switch on the power supply. In this condition, relay coil is not getting supply voltage, so the pole of NC terminal are shorted with each other, and since we have connected a light bulb with this terminal in series with AC power supply, so it gets lightened. Now as you turn on the toggle switch, coil of relay will get supply voltage, and hence the NC point of relay is separated from the pole, and NO point of the relay attracted towards pole and make contact with pole. Since we have connected a buzzer with these terminals in series with AC power supply, so buzzer gives the sound of frequency 50 Hz. When we switch on this toggle switch, buzzer is on, then we off this switch, light is on. So this is the object 13. Study the relay and construct a switching circuit by using relay. Now we are going to object 14, study of all state experiment. For this experiment, remove all previous connections. Take a 800 turn coil. We are going to do object 14. For this experiment, take a 800 turn coil. To study the all-state experiment, take a 800 turn coil connected to DC power supply as shown in figure. A figure is provided in our manual, and this is the figure. According to the figure, one end of this power supply is connected to 5 or 12. So now we have connected it to plus 5 volt power supply. Another end of this coil is connected to negative of this. Remove this U core. Now put the magnetic compass. This is the magnetic compass. You can observe the deflection of the needle. When we switch on the trainer, deflection of the needle is anti-clockwise position. You can see this is the deflection. Needle is deflected in anti-clockwise direction. Now interchange the connection of the coil. We have interchanged the connection of the coil and switch on the trainer. You can see the deflection of this compass, deflection of this needle is now clockwise direction. You can observe needle is also deflected reversely. This is the Oersted's experiments. So this is your object 14. Object 15 is to study the phenomena of mutual induction. For this experiment, take a U core. To underturn and 32 underturn coil and U core from the given accessory. This is your U core. And take a 200 turn coil. This is 200 turn coil. And another side, put the 3210 coil. This is 3210 coil. Fit the U-core on the bracket. We have fitted this already. Place the 210 coil. This is 210 coil as a primary, and this is 3210 coil as a secondary winding. Now connect the one end of 210 coil to positive terminal of DC power supply. And the other end of terminal switch. By a switch, you can connect another end of this coil to the negative supply by a toggle switch. Make common to the negative terminal of DC power and other terminal of switch. Now switch on the trainer board at toggle switch in the circuit. As the switch is on, the pointer of galvanometer will give a sudden kick in one direction, and this is your 3210 coil connected to the galvanometer. Switch on the trainer. When the toggle switch is on, the pointer of galvanometer will give a sudden kick in one direction. Now we are going to put it in one direction. This is sudden kick to left side. Now when the toggle switch is turned off, the galvanometer will give deflection to the right. Now we are going to put this switch to off position, and this is the sudden kick to right direction. When you put this switch to on position, this is the left side deflection, and when you put this switch to off position, deflection is in right direction. We have observed that when switch is on, the current in the primary being to increase from zero to maximum during the growth of current. The magnetic flux linked with the primary being to increase, and since secondary is very near to primary coil, so it linked magnetic flux is also increases. Hence current is induced in secondary. Now according to the Lenz law, the direction of the current in secondary is such as to oppose the growth of power supply current in the primary. So the deflection of galvanometer is because of secondary induced current. When the switch is turned off, the current in the primary coil begins to decrease towards zero. So the magnetic flux linked with primary and as well as secondary also decreases. So detailed theory and detailed explanation of this deflection is given in our manual. You can read the detailed explanation about this mutual inductance phenomena of this mutual inductance. So this was the object 15, the phenomena of mutual inductance. Now we are going to object 16. Construct and study the step-down transformer with the help of given coil and cores. For this experiment, this is the circuit diagram. Take two 400 coils from the coil set, the 400 ton coil. This is one 400 ton coil. This is another 400 ton coil. These are the two 400 ton coil set. Take U-shape, this is U-shape core, and fit it on the trainer board with the help of a screw. Fit this U-core on the trainer. Now insert one 400 ton coil in U-core as a primary. And other as a secondary. This is another 400 ton coil and use it as a secondary. Also put I-shape core on the U-core to complete the flux linkage. This is I-shape core, and put this I-core on this U-core to complete the flux linkage. Connect primary coil to the DC power supply. This is your primary, and connect it to DC power supply. This is DC power supply, 5 volt. Measure the secondary voltage with the help of multimeter. Observe the result. There will be no output voltage. With the help of this multimeter, you can measure the voltage. You can connect it multimeter terminal which are provided on the trainer and connect the multimeter. This is a multimeter. Now your multimeter is connected across the secondary coil, secondary 400 turn coil. Switch on the trainer. You can see there is no output voltage in DC range and also in AC range. No output voltage, you can see. These are some voltage because of the AC components in DC power supply. There are some AC component in DC power supply, so this is some output in secondary because of that these AC component. Now change the power supply from DC to AC. Now we have changed this DC voltage to 6 volt AC power supply. Now measure the secondary voltage in multimeter. There will be some reading, and this is the secondary reading, 4.3 volt AC. These are not ideal transformers since coils are not coaxially wound on the same core. The losses are more, or the voltage transformation ratio is proportionately below the ideal value on number of turns per coil, but effective quantitative investigation can be done with the help of this setup. Note the reading. Ideally it should be same as input voltage because number of turns are same. Also note the percentage of losses. It will be helpful for further pair of coil and for their calculation. Now connect 210 coil in secondary and measure the voltage. You can observe the voltage is lowered. Switch off the trainer and connect the 210 coil. This is your 210 coil. Connect multimeter. Switch on the trainer. Now voltage is lowered. In the same way, you can connect any large number of coil as a primary and can record the result for different lower turn secondary coil in the table. You can change the type of core and observe the result. So this is your object 16. Construct and study the step down transformer with the help of given coil and core. Now we are going to object 17. Object 17 is to construct and study the step up transformer. For this, this is 210 coil, this is 410 coil. Connect this 410 coil as a primary, and for the step up, connect large number of coil as a secondary. This is 810 coil, connect it as a secondary. For the construction of a step up transformer, connect the voltmeter. This is a step up transformer. Your input is 6 volt and output is 7 volt. Secondary is 7 and input is 6. So this is your step up transformer. Try this for another turns coil. This is 1600 turn coil. You can use this 1600 turn coil as a secondary. You can also use this 3200 turn coil as a secondary and study the step up transformer with the help of these cores. Now we are these coils and cores. We are going to object 18. 18 says to study the effect of moving I core on a step up transformer. For this experiment, take U core and fit it on the trainer board. Take a 400 turn coil. This is the another setup for this experiment. Take a 400 turn coil. This is 400 turn coil as a primary, 800 turn coil as a secondary. This is your 800 turn coil as a secondary. Now take U-shape small object and I-core with long screw from accessories. Now fit the object on U-core in such a way that long screw of I-core should be matched with the given hole on the object when I-core is placed on U-core. We have already done it. Tight the bottom screw of object and its extreme and upper screw of object slightly less than its extreme position. Now if you move the long screw of I-core, the I-core will move from its position towards upper or lower direction. You can move this I-core with the help of this screw. This is upper direction with the help of this screw, and with the help of this screw you can set it to lower position. Now this is in lower position and tight. So you can use this screw to set this I-core as a lower position or upper position with the help of this screw. So this is the arrangement for the study of moving I-core on a step up transformer. Now connect the primary coil to 6 volt AC. This is your primary coil and connect it to 6 volt AC and secondary to multimeter. You can use the multimeter terminal which are provided on the panel for the connection of this multimeter. Now connect the multimeter. Now your multimeter is connected. This is the multimeter. Switch on the trainer. If you move the screw, I-core will move, and because of that power linkage will be changed and can be observed in multimeter. So when you can see the change in output voltage. If you move the screw of I-core, I-core will move, and because of that power linkage will be changed. The secondary voltage is changed. If a light bulb is connected across the secondary, the effect of moving I-core can be demonstrated to the student. So you can connect the bulb also in place of this digital multimeter. So you can connect the bulb, and this is the bulb, and when you move this screw, when you turn this screw, I-core will move. And the intensity of bulb is changed because of the flux linkage is changed. You can observe the intensity of light bulb. So this is the object 18. To study the effect of moving I core on a step up transformer. Object 19 is to convert a galvanometer into voltmeter. For this object, detailed procedure are given in our manual, and this is the circuit diagram. First we will measure IG, galvanometer current. For this, connect this circuit. For the galvanometer current IG, positive of this 5 volt power supply is connected to a 1k resistance. Use a 1k resistance. This is 1k resistance. Positive of this power supply is connected to one end of this 1k resistance. Another end of this 1k resistance is connected to 10k potentiometer. My ammeter. So we can use this multimeter as a ammeter. So connect the positive of this meter to the second end of this 1k resistance. Other end of this multimeter is connected to 10k. See your 10k. Center point, and this end is sorted together. Another end of this 10k is connected to galvanometer. This is your galvanometer, and second terminal of this galvanometer is connected to negative power supply, negative terminal of plus 5 volt power supply. Switch on the tenor. You can see the deflection, some deflection in galvanometer. Now adjust the potentiometer such that to get full scale deflection of needle. This is the full scale deflection. Now measure the current in ammeter, and this is the current. This is 622 microampere. milliampere, and calculate the R with the help of a formula which is given in our manual. Now disconnect the circuit and adjust the potentiometer at the resistance which you have got from the formula with the help of multimeter. So Now connect the circuit as follows to convert galvanometer into voltmeter and to test it. You can observe that now galvanometer is showing FSD. It means it is calibrated for range 0 to 5 volt. If you connect 2.5 volt supply, the deflection of the needle should in mid position. So for 2.5 volt from 5 volt DC supply, connect to 1 kilo ohm resistance across the 5 volt power supply. These are the two 1K resistance. We are going to connect series of these resistances in across the power supply. Now center point of this resistance is half of 5 volt, means 2.5 volt. So you can see in the galvanometer, this is the deflection. Needle is in mid position. This is 2.5 volt and this is 5 volt. At 5 volt you can see in the galvanometer this is full deflection, and at 2.5 volt deflection is half, needle is in mid position. So this is the galvanometer conversion into voltmeter, and object 20, last object, is to convert a galvanometer into ammeter. For this procedure is given in our manual. For making galvanometer conversion into ammeter of range 0 to 50 milliampere, adjust the potentiometer 25 ohm given on planar board to the value of 1.2 ohm with the help of multimeter and connect it to the parallel of galvanometer. With the help of this multimeter, set 25 ohm port and connect it to parallel to the galvanometer. Now your 25 ohm is in 1.2 ohm position, and this is connected across the galvanometer. Now if you want 50 milliampere current in the circuit, of supply 5 volt, then you have to connect 100 ohm resistance. Adjust the potentiometer 10k for the value of 100 ohm. This is your 10k potentiometer. Adjust this to 100 ohm. This is 100k, 10k potentiometer. Voltage terminal of power supply is connected to the 10k potentiometer, which is set as a 100 ohm resistance, and another point of this 10k potentiometer is connected to one end of this galvanometer. Second end of this, second terminal of this galvanometer is directly connected to the negative of 5 volt power supply. Measure the current. Current is 50 milliampere. Set the 25 ohm resistance. Potentiometer for the full scale deflection in galvanometer. You can set it as a 30 milliampere galvanometer. This is your 20 milliampere, and galvanometer is showing the 20 milliampere current. This is 10 milliampere, and galvanometer is also showing 10 milliampere current. This is 15 milliampere, and galvanometer is also showing 15 milliampere current. So this is the conversion of galvanometer into milliampere meter, ampere meter, ammeter. So you can do the about 20 experiments with the help of this trainer, and trainer is electricity trainer. Order code of this trainer is 33515. Thank you.